How the history of modern nutrition science has shaped current thinking. Although food and nutrition have been studied for centuries, modern nutritional science is surprisingly young. The first vitamin was isolated and chemically defined in 1926, less than 100 years ago, ushering in a half century of discovery focused on single nutrient deficiency diseases. Research on the role of nutrition in complex non-communicable chronic diseases, such as cardiovascular disease, diabetes, obesity, and cancers, is even more recent, accelerating over the past 2 or 3 decades, and especially after 2000. Historical summaries of nutrition science have been published, focusing on dietary guidelines, general scientific advances, or particular nutritional therapies. 1234 Carl Sagan said, "You have to know the past to understand the present." And Martin Luther King, Jr., "We are not makers of history. We are made by history." This article describes key historical events in modern nutrition science that form the basis of our current understanding of diet and health and clarify contemporary priorities, new trends, and controversies in nutrition science and policy. 1910s to 1950s, era of vitamin discovery. The first half of the 20th century witnessed the identification and synthesis of many of the known essential vitamins and minerals and their use to prevent and treat nutritional deficiency-related diseases, including scurvy, beriberi, pellagra, rickets, xerophthalmia, and nutritional anemias. Casimir Funk in 1913 came up with the idea of a vital amine in food, originating from the observation that the hulk of unprocessed rice protected chickens against a beriberi-like condition. 5. This vital amine or vitamin was first isolated in 1926 and named thiamine, and subsequently synthesized in 1936 as vitamin B1. In 1932, vitamin C was isolated and definitively documented, for the first time, to protect against scurvy, some 200 years after ship surgeon James Lyne tested lemons for treating scurvy in sailors. By the mid-20th century, all major vitamins had been isolated and synthesized. Their identification in animal and human studies proved the nutritional basis of serious deficiency diseases and initially led to dietary strategies to tackle beriberi, vitamin B1, pellagra, vitamin B3, scurvy, vitamin C, pernicious anemia, vitamin B12, rickets, vitamin D, and other deficiency conditions. However, the chemical synthesis of vitamins quickly led to food-based strategies being supplanted by treatment with individual vitamin supplements. This presaged modern-day use and marketing of individual and bundled multivitamins to guard against deficiency, launching an entire vitamin supplement industry. This new science of single nutrient deficiency diseases also led to fortification of selected staple foods with micronutrients such as iodine in salt and niacin, vitamin B3, and iron in wheat flour and bread. These approaches proved to be effective at reducing the prevalence of many common deficiency diseases, including goiter, iodine, xerophthalmia, vitamin A, rickets, vitamin D, and anemia, iron. Foods around the world have since been fortified with calcium, phosphorus, iron, and specific vitamins A, B, C, D, depending on the composition of local staple foods. As one of the great accidents of nutrition history, this new science and focus on single nutrients and their deficiencies coincided with the Great Depression and Second World War, a time of widespread fear of food shortages. This led to even further emphasis on preventing deficiency diseases. For example, the first recommended dietary allowances, RDAs, were a direct result of these concerns when the League of Nations, British Medical Association, and the US government separately commissioned scientists to generate new minimum dietary requirements to be prepared for war. In 1941, these first RDAs were announced at the National Nutrition Conference on Defense, providing new guidelines for total calories and selected nutrients including protein, calcium, phosphorus, iron, and specific vitamins. These historical events established a precedent for nutrition research and policy recommendations to focus on single nutrients linked to specific disease states.